I think when the PSD opportunity came about, it was something that we had been talking about for a while of what can we do different. I saw what they were doing with Jimmy Butler and Chandler Parsons and Kyrie Irving. And I really, we loved it. I loved what direction they were going in. I thought that they were cool. They were young. You know, they're great to work with. So we really thought that we had something really cool here. The Tiger actually, and like this whole shoot, the whole shoot that actually came about, if you had seen what we had done with the Brett Favre photo, the comedy behind that, mm-hmm. is kind of what we were technically going for this. And of course, again, the media is going to think, oh, he's being cocky and arrogant. And if that wasn't the case, that's what we were trying. It was trying to be a funny thing, another recreation of, you know, a Brett Favre, an old school iconic photo. And then you've got kind of the hangover side. So for us, like, look at the Richard Shermans, look at the Steve Smiths, you know, look at all of these guys that actually say crazy things or do crazy things, but guess what? Their marketing is up here. Mm-hmm. So let's push that envelope. I think when you have a talent that has that personality, you have to use that to your advantage, and not in a negative way by any means, but definitely somewhere along the lines of let's push this envelope a little bit and let's challenge people and see what they actually feel and how they actually react. And I think we got the reaction that we wanted, to be honest. It's been extremely successful so far. I think, you know, it was a little bit ballsy of us to do it, you know, right before the season starts and, you know, him not being a starter, but I don't think you make any waves unless you're ballsy and you take that risk. And it wasn't, again, it really wasn't a risk to us because we know the brand, and I think what they've done is a great job with the others. And we also shot behind the scenes of the actual shoot, and we're going to launch that soon enough, but it's going to change everyone's opinions again. So it's almost kind of like, oh, you want to talk and you want to say negative things about it, but wait until you see this video, because he was scared to death of the Tiger, number one. And number two, he wanted to fire us.
Yeah, we might not have a job.
So really, like, it's actually comedy, and that's what it was supposed to all be. It's just comedy about it, you know? And I think that's what the way you push the envelope, especially in the digital scene nowadays. You know, if you have that big personality, you've got to use it to your advantage. And again, you know, him coming out with, you know, the standard, you know, you look at other guys that have just branded posts, their whole entire Instagram feed, and it's like, what are you doing? You don't even associate with that brand. Like, do you even drink Pepsi? You know, like, so for us, I thought it, you know, it has to be something that's personal and has to really resonate. And, you know, even in the Behind Baker documentary, he goes, I never thought I'd have my own underwear line. Like, you know, like, so to him, he was surprised by it and he loved it. And we had fun with it. It was all supposed to be fun. And we actually shot that like in the beginning of the summer when he was here in LA, and people were like, oh, you should be focused on football. He wasn't, like, it wasn't that. No. So again, it's, I get what people see and I understand, you know, how that works. But at the end of the day, you know, you're not going to make any waves unless you push that envelope a bit.